want to turn your right siphon on so when you transition, you'll have it. So they should start blowing the chauffeurs here anytime.
Push mute on the music when we're when we don't want it on. Try to just put pause or mute.
Well, we don't want the Spotify playing like it's now, just turn it off here.
And it'll just shut that off. Okay.
We don't want to turn that on and off. We just want to adjust the volume.
Take a seat. We We're just gonna go through the evening real quick so you guys kind of have an idea of what's going on. Some of you have been with us before, some of you have not. So we're just gonna give you a heads up of what you're getting into. So if you haven't seen them yet, the bathrooms are there. There's also some other bathrooms through there. So try to use those ones, but if those are used, go out, you can go through that door and they're on the right side. You've seen the coffee stations, they're hot. Go ahead and get yourself coffee, tea, whatever you please over there. And the nursing mamas, there's a section over there behind this barrier here, and kind of behind the Holy of Holies, there's a couch back there for mamas, or if kids need to kind of take a break, you can go back there, just so you know where that is. So through the order of the night, we're gonna start with the siddur. We're gonna go through a few parts of it. First we'll bless the kids, and then they'll get a little distraction bag. And then we'll go through the siddur, just a portion of it. We're gonna go to do the tabernacle walkthrough, which is something that we do here. It's nothing like the real thing, but it's the best that we can do with what we have. So we try to have you walk through what the high holy priest, what he would do, the high priest would do. And so we're gonna have you on the tables. There are little signs, and it gives you the instruction of things that you've intentionally done and things you've unintentionally done. And you'll write one on two different pieces of paper. And as you go through the tabernacle walkthrough, you'll be able to put them in the respective boxes. We will burn one after we've everybody gone through, and the other one we will throw in the trash because we are letting it go and going out into the nations. So nobody will read your sins or your struggles. And we want to remind you, these aren't things you're hoping to get over. These are things you've been working on, things that you have overcome. This isn't, as we say, like a wishing well by any means. This is a way to praise Yahweh for the things you've overcome this year. This is a way that there's no shame in that. There's rejoicing. You're rejoicing over what you've struggled through and overcome, and rejoicing for his goodness. So keep that in mind. It's not the things you're hoping or you're currently struggling with. It's the things that you have already overcome. So you need to remember, remez to the things that you have conquered. So you're going to put those in the boxes. You will wash your hands. There'll be two people in there to help you wash your hands. I mean, they're not going to help you wash your hands, but they'll be there to pour the water. Then you're going to go through, and the menorah station, there is lights under the basket. And Yeshua tells us to be not let our lights be underneath the basket. We don't do that. We put it on where? We put it up there, yeah. And so we want you to take the basket off and take a light with you to remind you of that. Then you'll go to the table of showbread, and then to the incense, and then to the Holy of Holies. It's all in your booklet. There's a booklet on your table in front of you. So there's a siddur, and then there's a tabernacle walkthrough. Those have scriptures describing everything. I wanted to give you just a heads up, just because it can be a little overwhelming if you're not familiar with the tabernacle. So there's that. Then we will go into some congregational praise and then dance, and then we will wrap up the siddur, and then we will break our fast if you are fasting. And so that's it. So we're gonna welcome the children up here to bless them. So kiddos, come on up here. Brian and Cornell, if you can come up here to bless the kiddos. We have a lot of kiddos today. A lot of kiddos.
Oh, Yavrataka runaiva yishmareka. Yaeva runapinavalika. Vikuneka. Yisadonai. Pinavalika. Vyasin. Loka. Shalom. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. And may the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen.
And may God make you like Ephraim and Manasseh, and may he indeed make you like Sarah, Rivka, Rachel, and Leah, and Miriam, the mother of our Yeshua. May you be blessed and eternally favored by Yahweh. Amen and amen. Yisimcha Elohim ke'Ephraim ve'ki'Manasseh. Yisimech Elohim be'Sarah, Rivka, Rachel, ve'Leah, ve'Miriam. Amen. Amen. May Yahweh protect and defend you. May Yahweh shield you from shame. May you come to be an Israel, a shining name. May you be like Ruth and Ephraim. May you be deserving of praise. Strengthen them, Yahweh, and keep them from the stranger's ways. May Yah bless you and grant you long life. May He take you someone who will care for. Yahweh protect and defend you. May Yahweh preserve you from pain. Favor them, Yahweh, with happiness and peace. Oh, hear our Shabbat prayer. Amen.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat 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 Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat 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 Shalom, Shabbat 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 Shalom, Shabbat 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 Shalom, Shabbat Shalom,
hey,
Shabbat Shalom,
hey,
Shabbat 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 Shalom.
Thank you.
All right, shalom, shalom. Praise Yah. All right, we are going to begin going through our siddur. Then Yahweh spoke to Moshe, saying, on exactly the 10th day of this month, the 7th month, is Yom Kippur, the Day of Atonement. It shall be a holy convocation for you, and you shall humble yourselves and present an offering by fire to Yahweh. You shall not do any work on this very day, for it is Yom Kippur, the Day of Atonement, to make atonement on your behalf before Yahweh your Elohim. If there is any person who does not humble himself on this very day, he shall be cut off from his people. As for any person who does any work on this very day, that person I will eliminate from among his people. You shall not do any work. It is to be a permanent statute throughout your generations in all of your dwelling places. It is to be a Shabbat of complete rest for you. And you shall humble yourselves on the 9th of the month at evening. From evening until evening, you shall keep this Shabbat. One day a year, Yah asks us to have a holy convocation, a fellowship, to gather together. And it's the day where he offers atonement, forgiveness, releasing, a letting go and a setting free. It's a day that we look forward to all year, and it's a day where we should, as we go through struggles, this day should be the culmination of that, right? This day is when we can finally celebrate and rejoice and say that we have overcome. Also on this day, we say toward our future, and we'll be doing this later in this siddur, but we speak towards our future the vows that we are making with our bridegroom. Amen. So we'll begin with the Al-Khait, the confession of sin. So we ask if everyone would stand, if you can, if you don't have to. And we'll all read this together. Everybody ready? Elohim and Elohim of our fathers, let our prayers come before you, and do not hide yourself from our supplication. What can we say to you who dwells on high, you who know all things, both hidden and revealed? You search our hearts and thoughts. Nothing is hidden from your sight. We are not so arrogant, not so hard-hearted as to say, we are righteous and have not sinned. Truly, we have sinned. We have done wrong and acted wickedly and rebelled, even turning aside from your commandments and ordinances. Moreover, we have not listened to your servants, the prophets, who spoke in your name to our kings, our leaders, our fathers, and all the peoples of the land. Daniel 9, 5 through 6 again. Sorry, against you, you only I have sinned and done what is evil in your sight. Thank you, Elohim and Elohim of our fathers, that you forgave all our sins, pardon all our iniquities, and grant atonement for all our transgressions through Yeshua the Mashiach. For it is written, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. All right, you may be seated. want to stand on the shofar for me? Sure. However you want, just stand on the shofar. Do our four little things we did.
Sure.
Then the kingdom of Ashamaim will be compared to 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the groom. 5 of them were foolish, and 5 were prudent. For when the foolish took their lamps, they did not take extra oil with them, but the prudent ones took oil in flasks with their lamps. Now while the groom was delaying, they all became drowsy and began to sleep. But at midnight, there finally was a shout. Behold, the groom, come out to meet him. And then all those virgins got up and trimmed their lamps. But the foolish virgins said to the prudent ones, give us some of your oil, because our lamps have gone out. However, the prudent ones answered, no, there most certainly would not be enough for us and you. Go instead to the merchants and buy some for yourselves. But while they were on their way to buy the oil, the groom came, and those who were ready went in with him into the wedding feast, and the door was shut. Yet later the other virgins also came, saying, Lord, Lord, open up for us. But he answered, truly I say to you, I do not know you. Be on the alert then, because you do not know the day or the hour. If we would all stand. And after this, we'll have you guys do it again. We'll all read together. May it be your will, Yahweh, our Elohim, and Elohim of our fathers, to let the sounds that come forth from the shofar pierce our hearts. May we hear your voice in the sound of the shofar as we ascend and plead before your gracious throne for the pardon of all of our sins, those of your people, Israel, for the sin of the whole world, and for the speedy and anticipated return of our King, Yeshua the Mashiach. O Yahweh, receive us with mercy and favor as we return. Restore us to you, Yahweh, so that you may be restored. We may be restored. Sorry, renew the days as of old. And then we'll sound the shofars again. Return, Israel, to Yahweh your Elohim, for you have stumbled because of your wrongdoing. Take words with you and return to Yahweh and say to him, take away all guilt and receive us graciously so that we may present the fruit of our lips. And I'll read. We have sinned like our fathers. We have gone astray. We have behaved wickedly. Adonai, hear my voice. Let your ears be attentive to the sound of my pleadings. If you, Yah, were to keep according to our ill deeds, Adonai, who could stand? But there is forgiveness with you, so that you may see. Do not be like your fathers and your brothers, who were untrue to Yahweh, the Elohim of their fathers, so that he made them an object of horror, just as you see. Now, do not stiffen your neck like your fathers, but yield to Yahweh and enter his sanctuary, which he has consecrated forever, and serve Yahweh your Elohim, that his burning anger may turn away from you. For if you return to Yahweh, your brothers and your sons will find compassion in the presence of those who led them captive and will return to this land. For Yahweh your Elohim is gracious and compassionate and will not turn his face away from you if you return to him. Y'all read. Who, Elohim, is like you, pardoning iniquity and passing over the transgression of the remnant of his heritage? You do not retain your anger forever, because you delight in mercy. You will have compassion on us and will subdue our iniquities. You will cast all sins into the depths of the sea, as far as the east is from the west, so far transgressions from us. For his thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways his ways, Israel. Wait for Yahweh. For with Yahweh there is mercy, and with him is abundant redemption, and he will redeem Israel from all his guilty deeds. By mercy and truth, atonement is made for wrongdoing, and by the fear of Yahweh, one keeps away from evil. Seek Yahweh while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked abandon his way, and the unrighteous person his thoughts. And let him return to Yahweh, and he will have compassion on him, and to our Elohim, for he will abundantly pardon. And I will cleanse them from all their wrongdoing by which they have sinned against me, and I will forgive all of their wrongdoings by which they have sinned against me, and I will revolt. I will forgive all their wrongdoings by which they have sinned against me and revolted against me. I have wiped out their wrongdoings, like a thick cloud, and your sins like a heavy mist. Return to me, for I have redeemed you. Shout for joy, you heavens, for Yahweh has done it. But you, Adonai, are a compassionate and gracious Elohim, slow to anger and abundant in mercy and truth. Turn to me and be gracious to me, for you, Adonai, are good and ready to forgive and abundant in mercy to all who call upon you. Come now and let us reason together, says Yahweh. Though your sins are as scarlet, they shall become white as snow. Though they are red like crimson, they shall be like wool. But he was pierced for our offenses. He was crushed for our wrongdoings. The punishment of our well-being was laid upon him, and by his wounds we are healed. All of us, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned to his own way. But Yahweh has caused the wrongdoing of us all to fall on him. And he himself is the propitiation for our sins, and not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. Behold, days are coming, declares Yahweh, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Yehuda. Not like the covenant which I made with their fathers on the day I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Mitzrayim. My covenant which they broke, although I was a husband to them, declares Yahweh. For this is the covenant which I will make with the house of Israel after those days, declares Yahweh. I will put my Torah within them and write it on their heart, and I will be their Elohim, and they shall be my people. They will not teach again each one his neighbor and each one his brother, saying, Know Yahweh, for they will all know me, from the least of them to the greatest of them, declares Yahweh. For I will forgive their wrongdoing, and their sin I will no longer remember. Therefore, behold, I am going to persuade her, bring her into the wilderness, and speak kindly to her. And then I will give her her vineyards from there, and the valley of Achor as a door of hope. And she will respond there, as in the days of her youth, as in the day when she went up from the land of Mitzrayim. And I will come about on that day, declares Yahweh, that you will call me my husband and no longer call me Baal, master. For I will remove the names of the Baalim from her mouth so that they will no longer be mentioned by their names. On that day, I will also make a covenant for them with the animals of the field and the birds of the sky and the crawling things of the ground. And I will eliminate the bow, the sword, and war from the land, and will let them lie down in safety. All right, you can all be seated. Okay. All right, we can all read the next page together. I will betroth you to me forever, and yes, I will betroth you to me in righteousness and in justice, in favor and in compassion, and I will betroth you to me in faithfulness. And then you will know Yahweh, and I will come about on that day that I will respond, declares Yahweh. I will respond to their heavens, and they will respond to the earth. And the earth will respond to the grain, to the new wine, and to the oil, and they will respond to Jezreel. I will sow her for myself in the land. I will also have compassion on her who had not obtained compassion. And I will say to those who were not my people, You are my people. And they will say, You are my God. Amen. Okay, so we are going to do the tabernacle walkthrough. Remember, the booklets are on the tables there for you. Read through those passages before you go in. So don't actually read it as you go through each station. We'll never get to the meal part of this. So go ahead and read your booklets through, and we'll dismiss each table as we're ready. And then. We will get that ready here, and then we will take up the tithe. There you are.
Shalom. How's everyone doing tonight? Oh, it's a great night. So this is Yom Kippur, where Yahweh is gracious enough to forgive us of all of our sins. And he asked us to bring an offering by fire. I don't know about you, but that means to me that I had to work for what I'm going to offer. The thing that Yah's been working on me on throughout this whole Torah cycle, but especially these last few days, is where's my heart? Is my heart willing when I'm given this offering? Yahweh doesn't want it if our heart's not willing. This is not something you have to do, but he wants you to do. Do we love him? Are we grateful? And I say yes. Abba Father, my King, we just love you and we praise you. Thank you for the opportunity to come before you, confess our sins. Thank you for the graciousness you showed us by forgiving us our sins and giving us another opportunity to do what is right. Father, we just ask that as we step forward from tonight, that our hearts would be just clean from all things, so that we might walk before you as a spotless bride. Father, help us to be those five wise virgins that are prepared for when you come, when the bridegroom comes. Father, we just love you. We praise you. We just give you all honor and glory because you are worthy of all our honor and glory. And we pray these things in the mighty name of Yeshua. Amen.
Going through the tabernacle walkthrough, and I know we're still passing the box around. They're going to pass a little snack around for the kids, but as we do this, we're going to have music playing in the background, and I don't recall if they all have lyrics or not, but this is not a social time. This is not a time to socialize with your neighbors. You'll have time to do that during the meal. This is a time for you to prepare your heart as you go through the tabernacle, to try to put yourself the weight that whole high priest would have as he's walking through that temple. And so I just encourage you to either spread out and spend some time worshiping as before you go in, but just also just try to keep the kids. I know it's hard, but this is just something for you to prepare and to know that you've done the work, you're here, and that you're going to leave it at the altar. And you can't pick it up once you put it down. So just to give everybody around you the respect of that. So we'll go ahead and start some music.
Thank you.
got nothing to do. If you want to go through the tabernacle.
I see.
Thank you.
slide. What's that? Well, you just said congregation worship, so I was looking for that
praise,
slide.
Sorry, praise. Okay. Sorry. Yeah, praise Jesus, I didn't start it now. Is the walk on? So a few more people in there, but we're going to kind of transition into praise. But first, how was that for you guys? It's a very different experience. We have to just kind of visualize it. So we're going to enter into praise. So I would encourage you to get up and maybe spread out and just praise the Creator for giving an offering for us so that we can be close to Him. And allowing us to experience these feast days. So we're going to go right into praise.
Thank you. two, three, four, and you're gonna face out. One, two, three, four. Turn mine to your left. Over, side, behind, side, over, side, behind, side.
Okay. Praise Yahweh. So we, just so you guys know, your intentional sins are going to be thrown away here shortly. And the unintentional sins, the sins on the brazen altar, are being burned up right now. So all the evidence is going away. I did instruct them not to read them. All right. So at this time, we are going to continue this Adur, and we're going to go through. I can't see that close anyway. So we're going to pick up with the vows. So if we could all stand. And these are our vows. These are what we are reciting to Yahweh and promising to Him for this, for our relationship with Him and in this coming year. Okay, so we will all read these together. As your clean and spotless bride, I will walk as Yeshua walked, and always seek to be fulfilled with your spirit. I choose not to love the world or the things of the world. I choose to stop lusting and indulging in evil thoughts. I will honor you but by loving you with my whole heart and soul. As your clean and spotless bride, I will hunger and thirst for righteousness. I choose to be merciful and give freely instead of withholding. I choose to control my tongue and not speak foolish words. I will love my neighbor and bless those that oppose me. I choose to turn the other cheek and not make show of being righteous before others. I will not behave proudly, but will be full of zeal for you. As your clean and spotless bride, I will choose to not sin knowingly, and please reveal to me when I sin unknowingly. In all of this, Yahweh, lead me. Be gracious with me, and grant wisdom in Yeshua. As your clean and spotless bride, I choose to resist slander and gossip. I will stop neglecting my responsibilities and choose not to be selfish. I will put you first and will not participate in idolatry. I will pray at all times and choose to be thankful in all circumstances. I choose to be quick to forgive and not hold resentments. I will go the second mile and will choose to be patient and wait for you to lead me. I will do unto others as I would have them do to me, and I will not be greedy. I will not set my mind on things below, but set my mind on things above. I choose to not be anxious about the things of this life, but instead choose to trust you to provide for all of my needs. As your clean and spotless bride, I choose to follow your Torah, honor your Shabbat, give to you what is yours, and listen for your voice. In all of this, Yahweh, lead me, be gracious with me, and grant me wisdom in Yeshua HaMashiach.
Where the heck did he read that at?
Okay, so traditionally, at a wedding, I remind people that by being attendees of the wedding, you're making a commitment to hold the people making vows accountable to those vows, right? And so we all just heard each other make these vows. So So we are all accountable to each other to make sure that we uphold our vows, right? And then we got it on video, right? Yeah. Okay, so there's evidence. All right, so this next part, I will read the first line. So for example, on that shepherd side, it says, you are Elohim, and then directly after that, you guys will repeat, we are your people, right? Okay, here we go. You are our Elohim.
We are your people.
You are our Father.
We are your children.
You are our Master.
We are your servants.
You are our Shepherd.
We are your Father.
You are our Head.
We are your Body.
You are our Vine.
We are your branches.
You are our Creator.
We are your
You are our potter.
We are your life.
You are our king.
We are your subjects.
You are our bridegroom.
We are your bride.
We were weak.
You are our strength.
We were defenseless.
You are our fortress.
We were oppressed.
You are our deliverer.
We were wounded.
You are our healer.
We are hungry.
You are the bread of life.
We are thirsty.
You are living water.
We were weary.
You are a sound of rest.
We were evil.
You are our righteousness.
We were foolish.
You are our wisdom.
We were in darkness.
You are our light.
We were lost.
You are the way.
We were deceived.
You are the truth.
We were dead.
You are our life.
We were in bondage.
You are redemption.
We are nothing.
You are all alone.
We are your worshippers. Hey, you can all be seated. Blessed be Yahweh, who has given rest to his people Israel in accordance with everything that he promised. Not one word has failed of all of his good promise, which he promised through Moshe, his servant. May Yahweh our Elohim be with us, as he was with our fathers. May he not leave us nor forsake us, so that he may guide our hearts toward himself, to walk in his ways and to keep his commandments, his statutes, and his ordinances, which he commanded our fathers. And may these words of mine, with which I have implored the favor of Yahweh, be near to Yahweh our Elohim day and night, so that he will maintain the cause of his servant and the cause of his people Israel, as each day requires, so that all people of the earth may know that Yahweh is Elohim. There is no one else. Your hearts, therefore, shall be wholly devoted to Yahweh our Elohim, to walk in his statutes, and to keep his commandments, as at this day. Amen. Okay, so we are almost ready for the food. We will be...
Meal blessing.
We will be doing the same as we did with the tabernacle walkthrough, releasing kind of table by table. And just a reminder, when we do get to the dessert phase, especially parents, pay attention when your kids put the fruit in the chocolate. If they drop anything in there, we need to make sure we get that out or it'll stop the whole thing up. So let's just be diligent about that. I don't believe that'll come out until after the first round of food, right?
They gotta confer.
Keep talking.
Keep going.
All right, so what we're gonna do,
Baruch,
play some music.
What did you say? What?
Yeah. So we'll play another song, and we can talk amongst ourselves and pray.
Okay, we're not going to pray. So it's happening.
Pray shortly, and people will start dismissing tables.
We're not quite ready over here.
soon as we're ready, we will say the blessing before we eat. And then again, once we are satisfied, we'll bless Yahweh, right? Amen.
Bifocals? This was the tabernacle mix, so.
Go down to the third one. Next one down. Find the next one. I'm looking for.
B-stage.
Sorry, don't try that.
Should I just cut it short?
Just double click on it.
Was it not playing Feast Days?
Yeah, it was. It just...
Oh. So much for this being a beat.
Yeah, no. Alright, let's go on down a little bit. Scroll down a little bit more.
No dance songs?
Yeah, where was dance songs?
Right there.
There you go, go with them. Those are usually a little more upbeat.